أفضل الصلاة وتم التسليم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما وعملا متقبلا يا أرحم الراحمين. Oh Allah, teach us what benefit us, increase us in knowledge, in good morals and in good deeds, يا أرحم الراحمين. Quick hadith before we go to the tajweed. Quick hadith, as we mentioned, we're going to mention one of the hadith, a hadith of the merits of memorizing the Quran. The Prophet ﷺ says that the one who's reciting the Quran while he's skillful, then he will be with the angels. He will be with the angels. مع السفرة الكرام البرر, with the noble scribes, with the noble angels. But the one who's reading it while he's hesitating and stubbing and finding difficulty, he will have double reward. He will have a double reward. Why? Because he's putting an effort. So don't get frustrated when you're reading and we're stubbing you and correcting you and you're... No, you, the more effort you do, the more rewards you get from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this applies also to your memorization. When you're memorizing and you're finding difficulty, you're forgetting. Put your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and know that you will have more rewards. The more you do, the more effort you put, the more rewards you get. And remember, the memorizer of the Quran will get a great crown on the Day of Judgment. A crown whose light is brighter than the sun, right? The light of that crown is brighter than the sun, greater than the light of the sun. Imagine. And your parents will be given garments that have no match in this world. And when they ask, they will say, why we are being given this? It will be said, because your child learned the Quran. So all of these rewards will not be given to someone who is not willing to put any effort, right? It will be for those who will put an effort and who will show patience and who will repeat the ayah once and twice and thrice and four times and four. They will repeat and they will put efforts, right? Not for those who will not. And there are many, many, many more encouraging ahadith, inshallah. We will take more as we move on in the tajweed class. The last, this is rule number 7, Ikhfa part 2. We started the Ikhfa last time, and believe me, this is one of the rules that many, many people, even some reciters who have recordings on the internet and who appear on TV, many of them, they have mistakes in applying the Ikhfa. So pay attention, and I'm breaking it into many small pieces so that inshallah you can get it right and you can understand. Last time we talked about the ikhfa, the first group of the ikhfa, or the first part of the first group. In ikhfa we have three groups of the ikhfa letters. How many groups?
Three
groups. The first group, or we apply to them a method that I call touch then press. What do you call it?
Touch then press.
So the touch then press method, this is one method. The other method is bring it close then touch. That's the second method. The third method is bring it close then closer. So there's no touching in it. Now we are taking only, still we are taking touch then press. Touch then press, we have 6 letters. Last time you took 3 letters, today we will take 3 more letters. Then we'll finish the first method today, inshallah. What were those 3 letters? Who knows them? What were they?
Mim, Sakinah.
What were the 3 letters of the first?
Mim.
What? Last class, we said if we have Nun, Sakinah, or Tanween followed by 3 letters.
Oh.
What are they? What are they?
Zal
and guys, you have to review. You have to review. We're gonna have a test soon, inshallah. We're gonna have a test soon. We said Zal and Tha and Va. These 3 letters. They call it al-huruf al-lithwiya. Tha and Va and Tha. Ikhfa, in these 3 letters, which method do we apply to it? Touch.
Then
press. Press. Touch, then press. Okay. Now the 3 new letters are Fa and Qaf and Kaf. Fa, Qaf, Kaf. So the method of ikhfa, which is touch then press, how many letters do we have for it? Six letters. What are they? Fa, ba, da, fa, ha, and ka. Okay, let's remember, it's the same method. Now I'm just gonna repeat with examples about these three letters. Same method, touch then press, it's the same method. Pay attention and focus with me. When do we have the ikhfa in the first place? When do we have ikhfa? When do we have ikhfa? When we have what? When do we have ikhfa? When we have what? When we have meem sakina or ra sakina or lam sakina. When we have what?
Noon
sakina or what? Or what?
Tanween.
Whether the two fathas or the two dhammas or the two kasras, right?
Yes.
So when we have noon sakina
or
tanween plus followed by, right? Followed by what? All of them or either of them?
Either of them.
Either of them. Then what do we have?
Ikhfa.
And let's be more specific. What method of ikhfa do we apply?
What method?
Tell me. Touch.
Then press.
Then
press.
Okay, how do we apply? Let's take an example. Look at this word, Surah Al-Naba, يَوْمَ يُنْفَخُ فِي الصُّورِ. Do we have Nun Sakina here?
Yes.
Followed by what?
Followed by
Fa. So what's the rule? Ibhar, right?
Yeah.
Huh? Who said yes?
No.
What's the rule?
Ikhfa.
Ikhfa. What method?
Touch or press.
Touch then press. Okay, how do we apply that? Who can remember? From what we explained last time, who can remember? Who can remember? How do we apply it? What do we do? We make ikhfa. Ikhfa means what? Remember the word. Ikhfa means hiding. Ikhfa means?
Hiding.
So what do we do when we do ikhfa? What do we do? Tell me, what do we do? We hide the noon. We hide all of the noon?
No. Yes.
But we keep something from the noon.
We keep
the window. Excellent. Listen. In ikhfa, we hide. What do we hide?
What do we hide?
The noon sakina or the tanween. We hide them. But we keep what?
We keep their gunna.
We keep their gunna, right? Yeah. How do we do that? Before that, let me mention to you something. How do we do the noon? All of you say an. Who can tell me what are you doing to produce the noon? Who can tell me? What do we do when we produce the noon? An. What are you doing? What you're touching with what? An. What are you touching? Say an. What are you touching? Your teeth or your gum? Your gum. When we produce the noon or the tanween, when we speak about the noon sakina, it's the same as the tanween, right?
Yes.
When we produce the noon, sit here, what do we do? What do we do when we do the noon? Huh? When we produce the noon, what do we do? We touch the gum plus what?
The noon.
No.
Plus the nasal sound, which is the gunna, right? So when we produce the noon, we do how many things? Two things. Touch the gum
and
make the nasal sound, which is the gunna, right?
Yeah.
Touching the gum with the tongue and making the gunna. When we say we hide the noon, but we keep its gunna, what does that mean? Does that mean we move the tongue to touch the gum or no?
No,
we don't touch it, right? Because if we touch the gum with the tongue, that's the noon, we're not hiding it. But what do we do instead of moving our tongue to touch the gum? What do we do? This is how. Now I'm explaining how we hide the noon. Instead of moving the tongue to touch the gum, what do we do? We don't touch the teeth, no.
Pronounce the letter before the...
So first thing, we pronounce the letter before the noon, sakin or tanween. In this case, which letter I'm talking about?
The noon.
In this case, which letter are we talking about? Yeah, exactly, yeah. So I say, look, you, I'm going to apply point by point, step by step. You, right? Now, what should I do? Step two, what should I do?
Touch the making of the letter.
Touch the makhraj. of the ikhfa letter. The makhraj means the place where the letter comes out from. The makhraj of the letter means what? The place where the letter comes from. So instead of moving my tongue to touch the gum, I should move my tongue where to?
To touch the gum.
My tongue or the other organs of speech, I move them to the ikhfa letter. To the?
Ikhfa letter.
And I press or I just touch?
Touch.
I touch. So touch the makhraj of the ikhfa letter. In this case, what is it? What is the ikhfa letter? What's the ikhfa letter in this case, in this example?
Yeah.
Who's saying that?
The moon.
Who's saying the moon? The fa, right? The fa is the ikhfa letter, right? So I should now move from the ya to where? But I should keep what?
The noon.
So here we should add what?
We should press to pronounce it.
The makhraj of the ikhfa letter.
Press to pronounce it.
With what? Here. We're gonna put it here. Ghunna is ongoing. When you are touching, what is going to the ghunna? Where is the ghunna? It's ongoing. So here, ghunna
is ongoing.
Is
ongoing.
Ongoing. When is it ongoing?
When you touch, when I am
prepared to pronounce the ikhfa letter. Now, when I touch the makhraj of the ikhfa letter, am I pronouncing it or preparing?
Preparing.
So we prepare to pronounce the ikhfa letter. While the ghunna is ongoing. How is that? Like this. Yum. Look, the ghunna is ongoing or no? Yum.
Yes.
Now, where are my organs of speech? In this case, the tongue has no relation because the tongue has no relation to the fa. The fa is like this, F, right? Touch the upper teeth, touch the lower
teeth,
the lower lip with the upper teeth. Say F.
F.
See, what are you touching? The lower lip with what? Upper teeth. So you should touch them. Touch them or press?
Press.
Just touch.
No, we say touch.
Just touch because we're not pronouncing the ikhfa letter. We're just preparing. So like this. Look at me. Yum. Say. Yum. So now is the ghunna going? Yes.
Yes.
Am I touching? Am I prepared to pronounce the ikhfa
letter? Yes.
Then what should I do? For how long I should make the ghunna? Yum. For how long? Is it longest?
No.
Ghunna or long?
Long ghunna.
Longest ghunna.
Long ghunna, right? When do we apply longest ghunna? We explained this.
Hold on. I'll catch
one. Two ghunna letters. Idgham with ghunna and idgham.
Shafawi.
Shafawi. That's longest ghunna. Now, when do we have long ghunna? Ikhfa. Ikhfa shafawi and?
Ikhfa.
And ikhfa shafawi and?
Ikhfa.
What's going on? You don't have to answer every question if you don't know. Okay? Ikhfa, ikhfa shafi and what? And qalb. Put your hand. Ikhfa and ikhfa shafi and qalb. So this is why we're taking them together. So in ikhfa, we apply long ghunna. Like this. Yum. Then what should I do? Last step. What should I do? I should pronounce the ikhfa letter. How?
How?
Don't speak without permission. How? What do I do? What's the last step?
The fa.
What's the last step? It's here. Huh? It's here.
Press.
We press. Press to pronounce it. So, yum fi. Yum fa. Say, yum fa hu.
Yum
fa hu.
Yum fa hu.
Did you pay attention?
Yes.
There are some mistakes here, some people say. They say yon, yon. Is that correct? Yon. Why? Who can tell me? If you know, you will get 3 points. 3 points. If you know. Why is this wrong? Yon, yon, fahu. Yon, fahu. Why is this wrong?
They're not pressing the lower.
No, it's not pressing. It's not about pressing. Huh? What is the mistake that I'm doing?
You're not prepared to pronounce it.
You're right. Particularly how? What am I missing? What am I missing?
The
Sit down. Don't raise your hand, please. What? What am I missing?
You are missing touch and press.
Exactly. Touching. The touching. Exactly, yeah. Right?
So is that correct?
We're missing the touch. I'm not touching. Yeah. I should touch the makhraj, not you. Then I go to the fa. No, go to the fa right after the ya. Like this. Yum. Say yum.
Yum.
Yum fahu. Any questions so far? Another example. Another example. Anfusakum. Tell them, Yashaya, see who turned it off. Anfusakum. How do you apply Anfusakum? Same thing. Look at me. What letter will you have to pronounce first? What letter? Before the noon. What's the letter?
Yeah.
We are here. What's the letter? Hamza. This is not Alif. This is Hamza. Ah. So we say ah. Then what should I do? Go to the... To what letter?
To the fa letter.
What is it?
Fa.
To the fa, huh? Like this. Say. Is it?
No.
Is it like this? As some qurra do. Fusakum?
No.
Go to the fa right away. Touch it right away. Say. Also, don't do as some people do like this. Is it like No. It's not like this. Right? It's the bottom of the lip and lightly and gently like this. Then what should I do? Press. Get out, quickly, get out, 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 out. Anfusakum.
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 Second example, kutub al-qayyima. See how we do this? We have to touch. Here, the cough is produced by touching the roof of the mouth with the back part of the tongue. Say, all of you say,
Aqo.
Who can tell me, what did you touch?
The back part, like right behind your
You touch the roof
tongue.
Of the mouth with what? With the your back part back of your tongue. Say, Aqo. So when we do the preparation, we should touch like this. Kutubun. Say Kutubun Qa. Now tell me what's the mistake if someone reads like this. As some of you read like this, some of you, unfortunately, some of you learned the ikhfa in a wrong way. Some of you say like this, Kutubun Qayyima. What's the mistake? What's the mistake? We did not touch the qaf, the makhraj of the qaf. We have to touch. Say it. Kutubun qaf.
Kutubun
qayyima.
Kutubun qayyima.
One more mistake here. I'm trying, inshallah, to teach you the most professional way, inshallah. A common mistake here also is the haraka before the letter. What's the haraka here of the ta?
Dhamma.
Dhamma.
Some many people they say kutubo bo. What's the haraka? What's the first haraka of the ba? It is dhamma. Kutubu. So you should say bu. So you keep the first haraka and you hide the second haraka in the case of the tanween. Pay attention. In the case of the noon, you drop the noon. In the case of the tanween, you have to pronounce the first haraka of the tanween and you hide the second like this. Because the second one is the noon. Like this. Kutubu. See, I'm pronouncing the first haraka, which is the dhamma. Kutubun qa. Kutubun, not kutubun bon. Did you hear? Many people read like this. Kutubun qayyima, right? No. Say it. Kutubun qayyima.
Kutubun qayyima.
Now we come to the calf. Same exact thing. The only difference is the calf a little bit in front of the qaf. Say ak.
Ak.
So it's very close. So the method is almost the same. Say minkum.
Minkum.
Is it right to say minkum?
No.
No. No.
Minkum.
Minkum.
Qawlan karima.
Qawlan karima.
See, huh? Qawlan ink. Say ink. Qawlan كريمة.
كريمة.
Is there anything not clear? Any question? Any question? جزاكم الله خير صلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه.
Yeah.